Hey there, everyone. Welcome back to Press for Truth TV. Today is Wednesday, August the 8th, 2012. And right now I'm currently uploading a video to my YouTube channel of an interview that I did last night with James Corbett of CorbettReport.com. And James has a regular radio broadcast every evening at 10 p.m. Eastern. And so he had me on the program last night for the full hour, and we talked about all sorts of different topics and good stuff. We had a good discussion there. So if you'd like to check out the interview, I'll put a link to that in the description so you can see it for yourself. And other than that, we'll move on to today's story, which, as you can see from the title, we're talking about bioelectrical implants and the evolution of so-called transhumanism. And that, basically in a nutshell, is this whole concept of man and machine becoming more intricately connected in the very near future. And we've obviously already seen some advancements in the medical communities with this type of a concept. For example, with pacemakers, electrical device that is implanted into the chest sends out electrical signals to regulate the heartbeat. So this certainly does have medical benefits to this technology. But also there are people out there, such as the military-industrial complex, who are very interested in this type of research because they've been dreaming for years now about creating a super soldier, somebody who would be bigger, stronger, faster, better eyesight, better hearing, and all kinds of things that they would like to see come out of this transhumanism movement and the mixing of man and machine. And I'll show you what Wikipedia's breakdown of what transhumanism is. Here's what they have to say about the movement. Transhumanism is an international intellectual and cultural movement that affirms the possibility and desirability of fundamentally transforming the human condition by developing and making widely available technologies to eliminate aging and to greatly enhance human intellectual, physical, and psychological capabilities. Transhumanist thinkers study the potential benefits and dangers of emerging technologies that could overcome fundamental human limitations. There's something of interest, fundamental human limitations. This is all starting to sound eerily familiar now with a group of men back in, oh, I'd say the mid-1940s or so, who were very interested in eliminating unwanted traits in the human gene pool and creating a superhuman race of the future. And these men are highly involved with eugenics, so we're starting to see a bit of a bigger picture here that is starting to emerge in regards to the transhumanism movement. It goes on to say here, these emerging technologies that could overcome fundamental human limitations, as well as study the ethical matters involved in developing and using such technologies. They predict that human beings may eventually be able to transform themselves into beings with such greatly expanded abilities as to merit the label post-humanism. And so it's quite remarkable here in the 21st century that scientists and medical experts are researching these areas of merging man and machine and getting us more closely linked to create these so-called superhumans, and also to potentially deal with problems that humans have, diseases and things of that nature. Which brings me to an article that I'd like to refer you to from naturalnews.com that came out today. And the article is titled, Big Pharma Shifting from Deadly Chemical Drugs to Bioelectric Implants. Not content simply drugging its millions of victims with mind-altering chemical and biological inputs, the pharmaceutical industry is now developing ways to literally transform the human brain into a drug industry-controlled biometric computer that will basically turn human beings into nothing more than mind-controlled robots. The Financial Times reports that GlaxoSmithKline, the drug behemoth recently forced to fork over the largest ever amount in fines for its massive criminal conduct, is leading the way in unveiling what the industry is now calling bioelectronics. The premise holds that certain diseases can be treated by injecting electronic devices within the body for the purpose of artificially controlling neural synapses and other activity. Moving beyond conventional drugs that interact biochemically with the body, Big Pharma will have built a big bioelectronics business that treats disease through electrical signaling in the brain and elsewhere, writes Clive Cookson for FT.com about the concept, which is expected to eventually replace many common drugs. Neurological problems from stroke and epilepsy to depression will be treated through electronical implants into the brain rather than pills or injections. Even diabetes and obesity will be attacked in ways that seem like science fiction today by sending electrical signals to malfunctioning cells. Rather than help the body naturally heal itself through proper nutrition, cleansing, and lifestyle, bioelectronics basically bypasses the body's own immune and healing systems and replaces them with remote-controlled computer chips that can be programmed and monitored by outside forces. It is the embodiment of the bionic man or cyborg concept, where human beings are taken over by computers and mind control. Presented alongside glowing results from a few recent clinical trials showing how the technology can be used to potentially help tetraplegics and other seriously injured or paralyzed patients regain function, bioelectronics has the very real potential to be used for much more sinister purposes, like controlling thought patterns. Yes, researchers are already saying it can be used to treat depression, as well as individual eating habits and preferences. Ultimately, bioelectronics treats people in a purely mechanical way where subjective personal inputs that may not always be helpful are bypassed, wrote one commentator in response to the FT.com piece. How long before someone suggests serial criminals are fitted with the bioelectrical patches that stymie endorphins and reduce the excitement associated with criminal behavior? Or perhaps release a toxin that makes the person ill if they feel stimulated in the wrong way. So certainly very intriguing that here in the 21st century, we are engaging in this kind of research and moving more closer to this Brave New World type of scenario in the future where man can be very, very controlled. And so, I personally took the red pill, so I've been unplugged from the Matrix and I would like to remain that way. And so anyways, guys, I just wanted to bring that to your attention today. So I'll put a link to that article from naturalnews.com in the description if you'd like to check that out. And also from there, you can learn a little bit more about this whole concept of transhumanism that we are slowly moving towards here in the 21st century. And that's it for today, everyone. I want to thank you once again for tuning in, and I'll see you all right back here tomorrow at pressfortruth.tv.